Morning class. Today I am going to start here chapters of second term, and in second term the chapters include 3, 4, 9 and 10. Before starting the chapter, I want to say here that I will use Hindi for those students who cannot be able to understand English completely. So now we are going to start here chapter 3, and the chapter 3 is the flower, in which we have to study these topics: structure of bisexual flower, function of various parts, a brief introduction to complete and incomplete flower, essential and non-essential wholes of a bisexual flower, their various part and function. And next topic is inflorescence and placentation. In inflorescence and placentation, we have to study only the introduction of these two terms. So let's start the first topic of chapter 3, that is the structure of bisexual flower and their functions. Now the first topic is typical structure of bisexual flower. यहाँ पे bisexual flower, that means the flower in which both male and female parts are present is known as bisexual flower. The flower in which both the male and female parts are present is known as bisexual flower. So now I am going to start the draw structure of a typical flower. Clear? This is the pedicel. Pedicel, that means the stalk of the flower. Pedicel, that is stalk of a flower. Above the pedicel, this one, the swollen portion is known as thalamus. Thalamus. And the other name of thalamus, this is also known as torus. Torus. Thalamus is that portion of flower on which all the floral holes are arranged. Thalamus is that portion of the flower on which the other part of the flowers are arranged. Now, I am going to start the draw structure of female part. This is the female part, which consists of three parts. The uppermost is for receiving the pollen grain. For receiving the pollen grain, this is known as stigma. This is stigma. Stigma for receiving the pollen. And this stalk-like structure is known as stalk. And last one is stigma, style, stalk or style, and ovary. And including all these three parts known as pistil or carpel. Clear? This is female structure. Stigma, the uppermost for receiving the pollen. Stalk-like structure known as a style or a stalk. And ovary. Within the ovary, there is ovule is present. Within the ovary, ovule is present. And all these three parts include pistil or carpel. This is female part. Now, next structure is male part. Male part, this one is anther and this one is filament. And including both these, this structure is known as stamen. Clear? Male part, stamen. This is a stamen. And for the protection of both these part, there are some non-essential holes, which is known as calyx and corolla. Calyx and corolla. Green leaf-like structure. This structure, which is green leaf-like, present on the base of the thalamus, known as sepal. this is sepal, which is usually green in color. And next is, this one is known as petal, the colorful part of the flower for the attraction of insect for pollination is petal. This is the structure of a bisexual flower. I repeat here that the stalk of the flower is known as pedicel. The swollen portion on which all the floral holes are arranged is known as thalamus or torus. Now the female part, stigma, style, ovary, within the ovary, ovule is present, and including stigma, style or stalk and ovary is known as pistil and carpel. And this one is the male part, anther and filament, and anther and filament including known as stamen. And on the base of the thalamus, here the leaf-like structure present, which is known as sepal. And the function of sepal is to protect the flower in bud condition. And the colorful part of the flower is known as petal. And petal function for the interaction of insect for the pollination. This is all about the structure of a bisexual flower.